Hey everyone, it's Mike. I review nootropics and I talk about personal development. And during this video, we're going to talk about piracetam. Piracetam is a nootropic that I discovered about 8 years ago and I've been taking it pretty much ever since. It's a unique nootropic in that it can really fit any stack. So whether you're using nootropics with the intention of decreasing anxiety or improving focus or maybe even something like improving motivation, it is a great tool and it's part of a beginner stack. So let this video be your guide. During this video, I will go over the benefits of piracetam. We'll talk about some of the side effects you should be aware of. We'll go over the appropriate dosage. And then of course, I'll talk about my personal experience in taking piracetam and what other nootropics can go really well with it. Stay tuned to the end of the video where I'm gonna rate piracetam out of 10. Let's get right into it. All right, so what is piracetam? Piracetam is a nootropic. And what is a nootropic? It's a class of supplements that people take to enhance their cognition. What that means is improve things like your memory, whether it's short-term memory or long-term memory, whether it's your energy levels, your motivation. You're looking at having an improved life across all areas, and piracetam is known as the starter nootropic. Very often people ask, Michael, what did you first start off with? And I first started with piracetam, and it's not necessarily that I thought it was the best nootropic. It's just that back then, a decade ago, a lot of the nootropics that we discussed on this channel were not so popular, and piracetam was just known to enhance cognition. It may not be the strongest, although it's a nootropic that goes really well with other nootropics. So what I really like about piracetam is that it seems that all the other racetams and other nootropics just work a lot better once I'm taking it. With respect to the studies, unfortunately, most of the piracetam studies out there are done with people with some sort of cognitive issue, whether they're experiencing Alzheimer's or maybe elder people who are starting to have some sort of cognitive decline. Although for people like myself in my late 20s or maybe you in your 30s, piracetam can definitely help to enhance cognition and it's relatively safe versus some of the other nootropics. One of the signs that you know piracetam is working is you'll notice that you'll have an overall increased work ethic. What that means is you will be more inclined to want to do work, whether you're studying or you're even a business person, or you're just engaged in projects. You'll find it much easier to neglect activities outside of you being productive, and that's where I really noticed it working. It wasn't until maybe 3 or 4 cycles until I noticed piracetam was doing something. For me, when I first started using piracetam, it was easy to evaluate whether or not it was working because I was in school, I constantly had exams, I had projects, and I noticed that I was just studying a lot more efficiently, my grades were better, and it wasn't until I took piracetam out of my stack until I noticed that I was just slower, it was taking longer to read, it was taking longer to retain information. I would need to study more to get the same results. There have been a number of times when I questioned if piracetam was working or not, especially because other nootropics like Nupept or like Pramiracetam, they are known to be exponentially more potent than piracetam. It's almost such that Nupept, they say, is supposed to be 10 times more effective. I don't necessarily agree with that. I do find that piracetam is helpful in ways that Nupept isn't. What makes piracetam a little bit unique to other nootropics is that you need to take it for a considerable amount of time before you start to notice anything. So with a lot of nootropics that I talk about on my channel, like modafinil or like phenylpiracetam or armodafinil, which are all very popular, you'll notice an immediate benefit. For example, you'll take it and a few hours later, you can see the results. You have more energy, you're physically and mentally stimulated. Whereas piracetam, it's a stimulant in a very subtle way. It's enough to notice though, especially if you do dose it right and you just give it a bit of patience. So my recommendation for anyone that does not notice piracetam, just watch, give it some patience and definitely dose it properly. When I talk about dosing it properly, what that looks like is 800 milligrams with a choline source 2 to 3 times per day for about 2 weeks. Then you'll know and then you can properly evaluate things. And if you look at pretty much all studies, they all show that piracetam needs to be taken for a considerable amount of time before people see benefits in those areas. When we talk about focus, when we talk about mood improvements, energy levels, motivation. Fortunately, piracetam is a very inexpensive nootropic. Therefore, going out and purchasing 1 kilogram or 2 kilograms in the powder is somewhat practical. The reason I mentioned choline is because when you're taking piracetam or some of the other racetams, it's more important that you replenish your choline stores. And the reason why is because you're just using more choline. It's almost like fuel. So the way you can do that is to replenish your choline stores through diet, which basically just means egg yolks. It's known that egg yolks have a lot of choline. Although the more practical way of doing this is by supplementing with choline. And there's 3 main ways you can purchase choline. You can purchase the choline bitartrate, you can buy CDP choline, or you can buy my favorite, which is Alpha GPC. It's been such that when I used piracetam with choline bitartrate, it really didn't do much. choline bitartrate is very inexpensive, and there's a reason why. When I then just removed choline bitartrate and replaced it with CDP choline, I could definitely tell it was working. My memory was better, my energy levels were better, and I overall just felt like a more energetic version of myself. I was still the same person, same personality, same emotions, but just more energetic, more focused, and a lot more motivated. So then from there, I started taking alpha-GPC as a replacement for CDP choline, and wow, I could tell it was working. And as I mentioned, everything from before, better focus, better mood. And because of that, alpha-GPC is my go-to. Even if I'm not taking piracetam and I'm taking time off of it, alpha-GPC, taking it at 300 milligrams twice or three times a day is very effective, and I just find that all of my nootropics are a lot more effective when I'm using it. So the ideal dose is something like 800 milligrams of piracetam with 300 milligrams of alpha-GPC three times per day. Ideally without a meal. I take pretty much all my nootropics without a meal, once fasted, once sometime in the early afternoon, and then once in the late afternoon, early evening, in order to make sure that it doesn't interfere with sleep. So give it some time. After about 2 weeks, then you'll be able to dose it in a smaller fashion if you choose to. Even 500 milligrams twice a day will be effective. Some users do report having a better experience when they use an attack dose, and what that looks like is just taking more piracetam only for the first week until it's somewhat saturated, kind of like creatine. For those of you who take creatine monohydrate, then you probably know that it's supposedly more effective if you take an attack dose. So you pretty much four or five times your amount of creatine you would take for the first week, and then you're saturated and you can get away with having a lower dose, something like 3 to 5 grams of creatine per day. Side effects, there's really not much you should be concerned about. With piracetam, a lot of people do report headaches, and if that's happening, then it's probably because they're not taking enough choline. It just happens so often that people notice headaches, but then they buy choline and they start to realize, okay, I can get the benefits of piracetam without having the headaches. Otherwise though, yeah, really no side effects you should be concerned about. Piracetam is just magical that way. There's no withdrawal either. There's been many times when I was taking piracetam for 3 to 4 months straight and I just took it out of my stack and I didn't really notice any negative effects. I didn't have any brain fog. I didn't have any issues with my memory and recall. And for that reason, I think piracetam is overall just a great nootropic to have in your stack. And one of the more underrated things about piracetam though is that all the other racetams work a lot better. And I've talked about other racetams throughout my channel. My favorite four racetams are piracetam, aniracetam, oxiracetam, and pramiracetam. Phenylpiracetam as well, although phenylpiracetam is a different class of nootropics altogether. That's something you would only take for one day. You wouldn't take it for two consecutive days. In summary, what aniracetam is going to do is it's going to help you with social anxiety, and it's specifically good for word recall. Combining aniracetam with piracetam and a choline source makes for a really good stack. Otherwise, oxiracetam is similar to Dupept in that it won't necessarily help you with anxiety, but it will make you more focused. It will make you more alert. You'll find that you'll be able to work for a much longer period of time without experiencing some of the fatigue you may usually do. And then pramiracetam really just has this unique ability to mute your emotions, be able to get you through repetitive work. So if you're somebody that is a student and you just find your work extremely boring, you're just able to embrace the boredom, you're okay with it, you're unattached to the outcome, and you're just enjoying it. I would say pramiracetam, if you're looking for something which can help you with ADHD issues, then pramiracetam is the best nootropic. And because I'm mentioning piracetam goes well with that, ideally you wanna try pramiracetam with piracetam with a choline source like alpha-GPC. That makes for a very good stack. Unfortunately though, pramiracetam is a lot more expensive and it tastes absolutely horrible. So if you do go ahead and buy that, then be sure to buy it in the capsule form rather than the powder. That's been my experience with the racetams though. They're very subtle, but you can definitely notice that once you cycle on and off of them. I've really found that I can do a proper evaluation once I combine them, and then I just one by one try taking something out of the stacks. For instance, I had my piracetam for a very long time and I was not using it. And then I was really enjoying oxiracetam and pramiracetam, and I thought, what the hell, why not just try adding piracetam to it? And wow, the stack really improved. If you were to ask me, should you cycle off of piracetam, meaning should you take time off, I've not necessarily noticed it's that important. Unlike some of the other racetams, with oxiracetam, I definitely noticed that by taking it day after day after day, it was becoming less and less effective, because oxiracetam is such that after one ingestion, you usually do feel a little bit more alert. But I noticed that I was feeling alert and then slowly it would just taper off. Although with piracetam, the only time I'm really taking time off is if I'm going on vacation or if I'm just out of the stuff and I have to purchase more of it. If you were to ask me, am I scared about some of the long-term effects? I'm not, because now it's been at least 5 years where I've pretty much been taking it maybe 330 days of the year, and I've not really noticed anything bad happen out of it, man. Yeah, that being said, I can see myself taking this for a very long time. It would be in my top 10 nootropics, maybe not my top 5, but it would definitely be in my top 10, especially because it's so inexpensive and it seems relatively safe. Don't see what's wrong with it. If you were to ask me what other nootropics would go well with paracetam, the answer to that would be adaptogens. And what adaptogens do are they help you to fight stress. So they make you a more resilient version of yourself. They build your capacity to tolerate stress, so you have a better relationship with your work, better relationship towards stress, and you're just more willing to get out of your comfort zone. So you'll find, like, with paracetam, it doesn't necessarily help too much in respect to anti-anxiety or depression, but more so it makes you focused, makes you energized, makes you want to start new projects and just be a more productive version of yourself. So therefore, combining paracetam with the other racetams that I've talked about, along with the adaptogens, so things like bacopa, monieri, ashwagandha, and rhodiola rosea, that would make for a very good stack. And that's a stack that I'm taking most days. I really enjoy it. With rhodiola rosea, it's going to help you to fight fatigue. It almost feels like a nap in a pill. Ashwagandha is going to help you to maintain a nice state of peacefulness, like a nice, calm, detached feeling to your work. And then bacopa is really going to help you when it comes to memory, and it can do some nice things when it comes to fighting stress as well. A lot of people report good benefits from taking bacopa. Paracetam, I would rate it 8 out of 10. It's high because it's so safe. It's high because I noticed the results. It could be higher if it was a little bit stronger. I really like Nupept. I would rate that a little bit higher, but paracetam is overall just a more suitable stack for pretty much everyone. With Nupept, a lot of people do notice a bit of brain fog, or they notice some sort of bad side effects, whereas paracetam, you don't have that concern. So really hope you found that helpful. If you tried paracetam, I want to know about your experience. Please do comment below. Give it a like, comment. It helps the algorithm, and I'll look forward to seeing you all next time.